So it's official, I'm taking my RX-8 to the track in September. But there are quite a lot of things that need to be done to my RX-8 before then. So if you don't want to miss on my RX-8 drift build and other RX-8 tips and DIYs, then hit the subscribe button because things are about to get toasty. And this will also be my first time on a racetrack, so I hope that all the hours I spend watching Initial D and Fake Taxi will pay off. And also next week I will take my RX-8 to the dyno to see how much horsepower there is left after 13 years. So I hope something above 215, but how much it will be exactly we will see next week, so stick around. So the goal for today is to go through all the mods that I have to do to my RX-8 to make her ready to go drifting in September. And also the second thing is to show you guys my list of performances that I want to do to my RX-8. So, you know, you guys that already been to the track, have some experience, can give me some recommendations, some tips, so this drift build can be built right. So let's head up to my laptop so I can show you guys what I've put down on my list for September.
Okay, much better. So here in front you have my list of things to do to the RX-8 before I go drifting. And this is just a short checklist of things that I think are important to change to ensure good performance and safety. So I'll start by replacing the restrictive cat with a D-cat. I'm still deciding upon this one for 135 quid or this other one that has this straight pipe kind of design, 3-inch wide, etc. Which is also the one I like more, and I think that the fitting will be better than the previous one. So if any of you guys have any experience with them, leave a comment to help me decide. Next up we have my rear calipers, and the issue with the ones I have is that the piston keeps getting stuck, and I got tired of fixing it and tried to get it to work, and so I decided to buy these refurbished rear ones so that if I use my handbrake the rear wheels will actually lock. And my rear discs and pads are almost new, so I won't change them yet. Next we have a fire extinguisher, and I bought this one out of precaution because the RX-8 generates a lot of heat, and if this heat suddenly turns into fire I want to be able to put it off before it causes any damage. Next up I have to change my oil and oil filter, and since it's only going to get colder I'll put the usual 5W30 inside and upgrade to 10W40 next year before summer, along with my favorite Calvin Klein oil filter. Next, I have to change my front brake pads. The discs are still good, but the pads are starting to feel a little bit sluggish, so I'll replace them with a pair of ETE pads so I won't understeer into a sheep. And the most important thing that I must have are 4 rims and tires. I found a good used set of 4 that should last the whole day on the track, so I think I'm covered on this area. Next, I've already flushed and refilled my cooling system, I've changed my transmission fluid, I've changed my differential oil, I've installed a new front and rear strut bar, I already have a helmet since I drive a scooter, and the last thing I have to do is bleed my brakes and replace the old fluid with a fresh .4 brake fluid that has a higher boiling point compared to the stock .3. I also have a jack and jack stands to lift the car, and I cross wrench to remove the lug nuts, so I think I'm good. So let me know if I missed something, but as a first time drifting checklist I think it's pretty solid. So let's move on to my list of future upgrades. And as you can see, this list goes more into detail and the parts also get a little bit more expensive, but that translates into more fun on the track once everything is installed. So we can start with the drop links that will help eliminate the anti-roll bar preload. Next, we have a whole bunch of adjustable suspension arms so that we can eliminate all the stock ones and run a fully adjustable set. Next up, I need a new exhaust manifold, and alongside the manifold I'll also add the D-cat I've showed earlier to make the exhaust less restrictive. Then we have the rear calipers that I've showed earlier, and here we have a new pair of front brakes, and I really like the way these TopTech ones look, and for the price they seem like a good deal. Alongside the discs I'll also put a fresh set of brake pads. Next up it's time for the zone adapter so my engine can get clean 2-stroke oil without having to premix. And one of the most important and exciting bits is a hydraulic e-brake, and I have these two options to choose from. I like the silver one because I know it has a master cylinder for the fluid, and I think the second red one has it too, but I'm not sure, so if any of you guys have any experience let me know. The next one is a cooling upgrade. Since heat is a major player in the RX-8 game, upgrading the radiator seems like a good move. Next, we have a set of 10 coilovers. Now, I was looking at the monotube model, but if you guys can suggest a better bang for the buck, I'd be very happy to hear about it. Next up, I'll upgrade the cosmetic temperature gauges of the RX8 with functional ones that measure my water temperature, oil temperature, and oil pressure. This way, I'll avoid overheating or any other issue caused by a malfunctioning gauge. The next item is an upgraded oil cooling system to keep the oil even cooler, since it only gets naturally cooled down without any fans. And to finish the full exhaust game, I'd put this NVIDIA exhaust cat-back because it comes with a TÜV certificate, which will allow me to register it for street use. And last but not least, a full body kit. Now here I'm still working on the details, but I'll leave this part as a surprise to give the build some mystery. So that is the end of my current list. If you guys have any suggestions or tips, feel free to write them down in the comment section so we can put together all the knowledge and experience that is out there and build a pretty dang good RX8. So if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up and hit the subscribe button so you won't miss out on my RX8 drift build.